is a quarter of one of the most iconic pop bands of all time. She is bringing us new music. It is a true thrill to welcome a real hero to the show this morning. Good morning, Agnetha Fältskog. How are you, darling?
Good morning, Zoe. I'm fine, thank you. And it's nice to be with you.
It's so wonderful to have you on the show. How have you been keeping? And how has your summer been? How is summer in Sweden?
Thank you. It has been very fine. June was fantastic with a lot of sunshine and not so much rain, but lovely, really lovely. So I took a bath. Yeah, several times.
Oh, it's wonderful. Yeah, June was really good here. It was very similar, and the rest of the summer's been interesting. But it's what we're used to. It's wonderful to have you on the show with such great news as well. What can you tell us about the new album, a reimagined version of your 2013 album, A+.
Yeah, that's right. It came as an ID. Suddenly, I talked with Jörgen, who is with me here, Jörgen Elofsson.
And
hello, hello, Jörgen. Welcome hello to the breakfast show.
Well, thank you.
He will help me with my English if I drop.
I don't think you need any help.
Well, the idea came up, and we had a little conversation about it, and we said that maybe we should do something else about this album. To make it was 10 years ago I did it, and we're gonna make a new remix of it and make it sound totally new sound, but the same songs. And at the same time, he had been writing a new song, and that's the one that is the single now. For me, it felt like, well, shall I do another one? And I did it. We didn't know about the voice, as usual, if it was there, but it was.
It's amazing to hear you say, you know, you worry about your voice and whether it's still going to be there. And having listened, you know, had a little peek, early listen, and you sound as young as ever. You know, it's such a gift, your voice.
Thank you very much.
And I guess you worry about it if you're not singing for a while and you're not doing that, you know.
Of course. It's the same with talking English, actually, because I talk Swedish all the time at home. And nowadays, it's not so common that I speak English. So I feel a little rusty right now.
You sound perfect to us, I have to say. I mean, if you asked us to speak any Swedish, can you even imagine what would happen? how is it for you, Agnetha, when you hear your music on the radio? Do you still have a little moment of, oh, gosh, that's me, that's us, that's something special?
Yeah, that's always nice. It's always nice. But I love music. Music is in my heart and in my brain all the time. I live and I sleep with music, you can say.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. What might you listen to? What sort of thing?
Well, I listen to everything, I would say. But I have, I must tell you one funny thing. It's I came into this old singer from England. What's it? PJ Proby.
Oh, yes.
Can you remember?
Yeah.
So
absolutely. Brilliant.
Right now I listen a lot to him, and all the songs from 60s and 70s. That was my childhood. I listened a lot to all these singers like Sandy Shaw, Dusty Springfield. I really love them, and they're still in my heart.
Amazing ladies, incredible performers, all the ladies that you've mentioned there. So tell us a bit about the single that we're about to play. This is a brand new song. No one's heard it before. It's called Where Do We Go From Here? What was the sentiment behind the lyrics in the song and the feeling in this song?
It was a good feeling, but maybe you should ask Jörgen what what this is all about.
Cue Jörgen. What can you tell us, darling?
It was actually not us writing it. It was basically a gift. We felt it just sort of came through us, and it kept going on in my mind all the time. And as we worked on, you know, reworking, reimagining your music, Agneta's music, right? This song was constantly there as well. It's like a little companion saying, I want to be part of this too. You know, it's like, so I sort of got a bit brave and I asked you. I gave you the song and you said, yeah, I'll do it. I love the song.
Yeah,
so
I
that's really the story. Of course, you said, oh, I'm not sure I can sing it, but I always say, yes, you can.
I always
sing anything.
That.
You can sing the
phone
book.
But I heard the demo first, and it was a girl singing it in the demo, and I thought I would never do it like she did. And then I said, okay, I try it. And it came out very, very well, and now very proud
Fantastic.
Of it.
Okay, we'll play it now on Radio 2.
Okay.
It is Agneta with Where Do We Go From Here?
Outside I'm cold, but I'm burning inside. Impossible, crazy, like snow in July. People keep talking, they keep passing by. The world could be ending, I wouldn't care why. What if you could be the one that I remember?
Already singing all the words. It's in our hearts. You can see why Jürgen was saying that he had that song and it becomes a gift. That was a world exclusive, Agneta. Beautiful. How does it feel to hear it on the radio for you?
It feels good. Yes, you never get tired of it, to hear yourself on the radio. That's really something. It's always a tensed feeling, you can say, about what are the people going to think about this. But as long as you have your heart in it and you have done the best you can, because I'm not so young anymore, and I'm very grateful that I still have my voice and a good composer beside me.
Thank you. Precisely.
Oh, I know. You're an amazing dynamic duo, the two of you together. You really,
thank
really
you.
Are. We all need a Jürgen, I think, in our lives.
Yes.
It's so fabulous. I have to say, we've been really blessed on The Breakfast Show that Annie Fried was on the show. I got to talk to Benny and Bjorn. So it really was the dream, Agnetta, to have you on the show. Have been quite a phenomenon. The band feels really very much like a force of its own at the moment with ABBA Voyage, which people, you know, are still... I know people who've seen it 6 or 7 times as well, and people still finding it and loving it. Mm. And Mamma Mia, of course, the musical and the films. When you announced, you know, the new records that you did a couple of years ago, it was a top news story on every channel, pretty much around the world. How did that feel for you all?
It feels very good. And this with Voyage, it's an amazing show. It's doing so well. And we don't even know how they did it, even if we worked with it a lot.
It's so clever. It's so clever.
It really is.
Jürgen, have you seen it? Have you seen the show?
No, actually, no. I haven't. I've been too busy working here with Agnetta's music. So, but I'm definitely going to get up there and check it out.
Jürgen, when you come,
I hear from everybody, it's crazy good.
When you come over, give us a ring. We'll all come with you.
Yeah,
oh, good.
I would love to come over often if it was not so far away.
I know. It's so good. We had Annie Fried on the show back last year, and she was talking about how special it is when you're together.
It's almost magical to sing together with Agnetta, because we have something special, as you know, not only voice-wise, but also as friends. And it's like meeting up with your sister, you know, and once we closed the door behind us in the studio, we felt at home, both of us.
Oh, my dear friend. Yeah, we have been going through a lot in our lives, and the time with ABBA was you know, it was 10, 12 years that we traveled together, we did everything together, and I would like to take the opportunity to send my greetings to the other three, and I want to thank all wonderful fans who has been with us during all years, and for all fantastic people who has told us which impact our music has had in their lives, both in sorrow and happiness. It really warms my heart.
You know, you're so right. Those songs have been with us through all the adventures in our lives. Mm-hmm. Like you say, the highs and the lows. Next year, it's 50 years since Eurovision, since you guys won. It's going to be in Sweden. I mean, it's written in the stars. If you're not there, then, well, you know, what can we do? any plans to do anything, do you think?
You never know anything about ABBA and when we I don't say anything about that, so
yeah, okay,
I'd rather be quiet.
Yes, good. I know, that's beautifully handled there. Okay. Fingers crossed for all of us. You wrote your first song when you were 6 years old. What do you think that little girl would think if she could see the success, the influence that you would go on to have, and the incredible career?
I had no idea. At that time, I just felt that I had so much music in me. And it developed. And when I was 15, I started, you know, with this dance group and toured around Sweden. So I have been touring a lot before we started ABBA. Music has been my life.
Yeah, absolutely. And what do your grandchildren think of your incredible career? Or are they a bit like the kids in our family, where sometimes they're like, yeah, that's quite impressive, and then they get on with their own lives?
I think they are really now starting to understand. Some of them were with us in the opening night in London, and they were crying, really. Yeah. Oh, grandma. Yeah, so they had no idea, I think, what I have been doing.
It must be mind-blowing for them to be able to.
Yes.
And thank goodness there's all the old footage that we can revisit as well. It's so good. Agnetha, thank you so much for the music. Thank you for talking to us. So much love from all your fans over here.
Thank you. And I would like to send it back. And thank you for having us with you.
Thank you so much. And Jürgen, you're an absolute superstar. Let us know when you come over for the show.
Thank you so much. I'll tell my wife.
Many thanks.
I don't want to talk about things we've gone through, though it's hurting me. Now it's history. I played all my cards, and that's what you've done too. Nothing more to say, no more race to play. The winner takes it all, the loser standing small beside the victory. That's a destiny. I was in your arms, thinking I belong there. I figured it made sense, building me a it feel the same when she calls your name. Somewhere deep inside, you must know I miss you. But what can I say? Rules must be obeyed. If it makes you feel sad, and I understand, you've come to shake my hand. I apologize if it makes you feel bad, seeing me so tense, no self-confidence. But you see, the winner takes. Oh,
say Agnetha on the show, Richie.
That was a moment.
So many people in tears listening.
Steve Wright.
Oh, hang on. Sorry, Steve. I'll come back to you in a minute. I'm fighting tears myself as well.
Special that was.
Talking to Agnetha, sort of thinking of 8-year-old, 9-year-old me doing dance routines with my dear friend Yol, who's not with us anymore, sending love to Amanda, her sister, and Claire, lovely Claire Yearly. And I think that's been the reaction from so many people, because she's been with us, for many of us, for our whole lives. Leslie from Derbyshire in tears, so wonderful to hear Agnetha. Andrew says, thank you for that wonderful chat. Massive ABBA fan since 75. I've been waiting for this for so, so long. What a lovely lady, says John in Kent. Kev, who's 48 this year, says, loving the new single. I've loved her since I was 5 years old. Love the new song. You're loving the new song, aren't
you? It's so good.
She sounds so young. Mark in Edinburgh thinks it's fabulous. Leslie from Derbyshire in tears, sending lots of love to all the ABBA fans who are tuned in around the world for that fabulous, fabulous chat. Richie, how's your travel? She's so special.
What a moment.
And Jürgen, what a superstar. A new favourite. He's welcome anytime.
And I've got my fingers crossed for Eurovision.